Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, TJ Manotok.
Good morning to our friends at The Rundown. Here are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. We begin with a fast-moving storm expected to hit the U.S. Northeast early on Tuesday.
Came into the school year without
authorities say New York City could see up to 8 inches of snow early on Tuesday before the storm moves north later in the day.
It's going to be low visibility, high wind gusts, ending by early afternoon, as well as up to 2 feet of coastal flooding along vulnerable shorelines. We're taking this storm extremely serious.
New York City public schools will close on Tuesday, with classes held remotely for more than 900,000 students in the nation's largest school district.
Our schools are still in session, just differently. And so the long gone are the days of just a snow day and everybody just has off. So we're going to have a big snowstorm, most likely, but our students, we expect for them to be fully engaged.
The Big Apple also issued a travel advisory, asking residents to stay off the roads on Tuesday so snowplows can keep them clear.
Beginning on our midnight shift tonight, thousands of New York City sanitation workers will be putting salt on every street, every highway, every bike lane in the city, and we will be prepared to plow every street, every highway, and every bike lane as soon as accumulations hit 2 inches or more.
Strong winds up to 40 miles per hour and coastal flooding were also forecast along the New England coast, as well as Jersey Shore and Long Island.
Let's go to Las Vegas for Sunday's Super Bowl showdown, where the Kansas City Chiefs cemented their status as a National Football League dynasty.
The Sin City Super Bowl showdown between the Kansas City Chiefs and the San Francisco 49ers ended with Patrick Mahomes throwing a 3-yard touchdown pass to Mecole Hardman in overtime, giving the Chiefs a 25-22 win over the Niners. This is the Chiefs' third Super Bowl in 5 years, making them the NFL's first repeat champions since the New England Patriots in February of 2005. One Filipino is celebrating the Super Bowl win with the Kansas City Chiefs. Last summer, the Chiefs signed wide receiver and kick returner Nico Romijo of Southern California as an undrafted rookie free agent. The Fresno State alum showed a lot of potential during the preseason. However, he was placed on injured reserve before the start of the season.
Still on the Super Bowl, R&B star Usher delivered a high-energy halftime show that featured surprise appearances by some of his most famous collaborators, including Phil-Am guitar virtuoso Her.
Usher delivered his greatest hits during his 13-minute performance for the Apple Music Super Bowl halftime show, singing, dancing, and roller skating on a glowing stage at the stadium. The 45-year-old Grammy-winning artist, whose career spans 3 decades, also got some help from longtime pals and collaborators Her, Alicia Keys, Will.i.am, Lil Jon, Jermaine Dupri, and Ludacris. The Phil-Am guitar virtuoso displayed her impressive skills during Usher's hit songs You Got It Bad and Bad Girl. After her surprise guest appearance, Her, a Grammy, Emmy, and Oscar winner, took to social media to share a throwback photo of herself as a child singing at a San Francisco 49ers game. The Phil-Am artist, whose real name is Gabriela Sarmiento Wilson, captioned it, "How it started versus how it's going. Who would have thought? Thank you, Usher."
And those are the top stories making the headlines in North America. You can catch more of our TFC News on our website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News. Log on to the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel and watch out for the ABS-CBN News app on your smartphones and tablets. I'm TJ Manoto. Stay with us, Kapamilya.
The U.S. pressing Israel to work towards a pause in the fighting in Gaza. The White House insists a pause could lead to the release of all remaining Hamas hostages. It adds, while progress has been made in negotiations for another truce, more work needs to be done.
We haven't changed in terms of our desire to see an extended pause so that we can get all the hostages home with their families where they belong, so we can get additional security assistance in, and we can see a reduction in the violence. We are still focused on trying to get an extended humanitarian pause.
I'm asking about a permanent pause.
I know what you're asking. What I'm saying is we support and continue to support an extended humanitarian pause.
The White House also welcomed news about 2 Hamas hostages freed by Israel's military during a raid by special forces in Gaza. But it asserts civilian deaths should be avoided. Reports say at least 74 Palestinians were killed during Israel's hostage rescue operation in Gaza. International Criminal Court prosecutor Karim Khan says he's deeply concerned over Israel's potential ground incursion in Rafah. He also warns the ICC is actively investigating alleged crimes committed in Gaza, and those who are in breach of the law will be held accountable.
The incursion, the reports coming out are alarming. The head of the Office for Coordination of Humanitarian Relief have expressed grave concerns, asked where are these 1.6 million people supposed to go. There needs to be great pause and consideration in terms of what are not only moral responsibilities and not political decisions. These are legal imperatives, and we have an international criminal court, we have independent judges to make sure that that law is also complied with.
Israel is not a member of the Hague-based court and does not recognize its jurisdiction. But Khan has said the court has jurisdiction over any potential war crimes carried out by Hamas in Israel and by Israelis in the Gaza Strip. The head of the UN Palestinian Refugee Agency clarifies he will not resign despite controversies hounding the organization. Major donors suspended their funding to the agency after Israel accused thousands of UNRWA staff in Gaza of taking part in the October 7 rampage. The agency is still appealing the decision, which it says will severely affect the already dire situation in Gaza.
I have no intention to resign. We have one government calling for the resignation. We might have other voices, but I haven't heard any other government. And for the time being, as long as I do believe we can continue to make a difference, I will continue to do this. If we would have had no pause or freeze of funding, our cash flow would have been good until the end of July. Our cash flow will suffer as from now, as from the month of March. It will be negative, expected negative 30 to 40 million in March.